Emergency, emergency, emergency. Suspecting two fire escapes approaching.
Loud and clear. Order your crew to Citadel.
Rentap 20, intercept the target.
Nama Pascal itu sendiri adalah singkatan daripada pasukan khas laut. Ratu Pascal mesti menguasai teknik-teknik peperangan khas tiga dimensi, iaitu darat, laut dan udara. Antara 120 ke 150 calon. Kita cuma dapat 15 orang sahaja. So, 15 orang ni adalah yang terbaik.
Pascal is different. When they go out there, you never know. Because some of their mission, they're not even allowed to discuss with anybody. Sometimes they don't even know where they are going. They only will be briefed when they are on site. That is how some of these operations are on mission, the secrecy of maintaining the integrity of the mission. So they just report to the station and get special brief, and that's it. When they leave their unit, they're all prepared for anything. And they do not know when they're going to come back, or if they're going to come back at all. That's why they call it special force for special operation.
Those heroes really inspired me. My story actually based on the Bunga Laurel incident, and Laksamana Anwar, he was the one who carried out the heroic act in Angola back in 1998. He really gained my respect. Not only him, the rest of Pascal, what they have been doing for the country.
On the incident, it was, I think, on the 20th of January 2011. At that point in time, I was the fleet commander of Panglima Armada based in Lumut. It was about midnight, and there was a call, and it was actually a report from my commander on board BM-5.
Panglima, Laurel 11 under pirate attack. Kapal tinggalkan konvoi di posisi 3 Charlie.
Semasa kejadian, saya merupakan ketua gugus tugas yang mengetuai kumpulan gugus tugas pengempu di Off Yemen. Panggilan kecemasan pertama diterima oleh Kapten Kapal Bunga Mas Lima, dan beliau immediately telah memanggil saya bagi mendapatkan arahan.
As soon as I got that report, I immediately informed my superior, which is the Chief of Navy at the point in time. I reported to him on the situation. He told me a very simple statement: do whatever necessary, you know, to secure. Immediately, I direct the operations.
Instruct kedua-dua kapal patah balik. BM-5, full speed ahead.
The idea is to make sure that we are able to be as close as possible.
Arahkan Captain Laurel 11, darken ship, dan proceed ke Citadel.
Citadel, where is a place where everybody can secure themselves, locked in from inside.
Sebelum kejadian itu berlaku, Kapten ada berjumpa dengan saya secara personal dan dia mengatakan dia berasa sangat risau kerana titik untuk kita melepaskan kapal setelah habis diiringi adalah kawasan yang tidak selamat seperti yang dijangka. Apabila 2 jam setelah konvoi dipisahkan, 5 orang lanun telah berusaha dan naik ke atas kapal tersebut.
The pirates knows exactly they have to find someone. Even one is good enough. They know that. That's how they happen. If you get to that situation, it is going to be a hijack situation. So they were actually going down and looking. In the Citadel, there's a communication radio. So we can basically literally hear the pirates knocking. You know, boom, boom, boom. And it was reported there. Now, they say, do not open. Just keep quiet. Do not open. All they need to do is just remain calm and do not open the Citadel. I know how our Pascal is made of. I know how they are trained. And I know how what they can do. And when I spoke to Maslan, I say, do not shoot unless you are being shot at.
Dan selepas keputusan diambil, saya telah memanggil pasukan pergempur bagi memberikan arahan.
Untuk tim pergempur, kami berada dalam 4 tim. Tim Alpha, Bravo, Charlie dan Delta.
We were doing negotiating, and suddenly I hear from the speaker a shot being fired, and I ask, who shot that? And they reported that the pirate. But at the meantime, you know, we had the team prepared. There was a report saying that there's one more vessel coming closer towards the Bungalora with the reinforcement would be out of control if they were able to break through the citadel. We must make sure that we do not allow that mother ship to come alongside Bungalora. BM5 carry a helicopter, but at point in time, the helicopter are only authorized to only fly during the daytime.
We are all capable to fly at night, but the ship that we were on board, which was Bunga Mas 5, were not capable to conduct night flying.
So there was a very critical situation. I said, I need to speak to the pilot, who was Lieutenant Commander Jason. He told me the weather is good, the visibility is good because it's full moon.
Lieutenant, kat sana malam, are you happy to fly?
And he told me, yes sir, very without any hesitation. I'm happy to fly.
Benda ni adalah hidup dan mati dan juga nyawa kru Bunga Laurel.
Then he say, fly helicopter, prevent the mothership from coming alongside the Bunga Laurel. So we get the orders to actually fire at the bow of the vessel. And again, they did ignore. And finally, we had to give that decision, shoot to kill. And that was when, you know, hundreds of bullets went through. It was reported that actually they can see the traces from the machine gun helicopter to the vessel. So a very tense situation because involving lives of the many other people involved, including the crew, and the situation happens more than 6,000 kilometers away from home.
Dalam kejadian tersebut, di mana di hadapan saya pada jarak lebih kurang 100 meter di hadapan sebuah lori awam yang syarat dengan membawa barang makanan dan juga penumpang telah diserang hendap oleh lebih kurang 5 individu bersenjata. Dalam kejadian tersebut, pemandu lori telah ditembak tepat di bahagian kepala dan kenderaan itu terhenti dan tersadai di lereng bukit. Jadi saya terus menjarakkan kenderaan lebih kurang 200 meter dan berhenti ke tempat selamat. Dan mereka bertindak ganas menembak ke atas orang awam sesuka hati. Jadi sebagai tentera pemerhati, United Nations Military Observer, kami tidak dibenarkan membawa senjata. Jadi saya berlari dan saya menjerit. Jeritan saya itu membuatkan mereka tergamam. Dan mereka berundur. Dan saya pergi bahagian hadapan, saya lihat pemandu dah mati dan kesan daripada tembakan lambang oleh penyerang tu, seorang wanita bersama anaknya cedera. Masa tu okay. Mereka bawa ke tempat selamat, iaitu ke kenderaan saya. Tetapi naluri saya kuat lagi untuk pergi semula ke lori itu.
Saya rasa ada lagi orang kat belakang tu. Jangan, dia tengah perhatikan kita tu.
Memang keadaan masa tu memang bahaya, tetapi naluri saya kuat lagi berkata, go back and find some more people who is really in need. Sebab saya dengar ada bunyi orang mengerang kesakitan akibat daripada kena tembakan. Saya terpaksa membahayakan diri saya kerana naluri saya kuat untuk membantu menyelamatkan nyawa-nyawa yang tidak berdosa ini. Dalam timbunan barang-barang itu, saya jumpa memang betul ada seorang lagi perempuan, anggota perempuan kena tembak bahagian perut. Padahal belum mengandalah dan saya ambil mereka, dia ni bawa turun, bawa ketenderaan.
Ketangkasan dan komunikasi baik semua pihak membolehkan tindakan Lanun berjaya dihentikan. Dan selepas hampir 2 jam kapal Bunga Laurel ditawan, tiada sebarang kehilangan nyawa manakala Lanun berjaya diberkas.
Not many people remembers this true events, and not many people will know except those who are involved. There are many other ops actually.
Tapi end of the day, kita kena sedar yang kita buat tugasan, tanggungjawab bukan hanya untuk diri kita saja, tapi apa yang kita perjuangkan dan apa yang kita tinggalkan.
Dan selalu saya berdoa, ya Allah ya Tuhanku, aku serahkan diriku, isteriku, anak-anakku di dalam pemeliharaan dan penjagaan-Mu, ya Allah.
And this is where not many people are aware of what we in the armed forces, in the security force, does to the nation. Where we provide all our services to the nation by being around and to be readily called at any point in time to do a mission.
I hope that I've done enough to make Pascal proud, the real Pascal proud, because I really salute the way they contributed their life to our nations.
Negara, keluarga, sama je. Menteri, kami yakin boleh selesaikan masalah ini. Diorang target pelantar minyak SPC, tuan. Bahaya, tuan. Sebab dia tahu semua SOP kita.
Negara jenis apa yang hantar askar untuk mati, ya? Shoot to kill! Jangan bagi dia cross ke Filipin!
Selamat petang, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan.
Where's the backup?
We are Royal Mission Navy. We are here to save you guys.